Hi, this is a spiritual crystal card reading for Scorpio for the month of August. So let's see what is your main energy. Main energy for August for Scorpio. And this is Platin. So Platin is telling you, actually this is the main energy, okay? To be careful not to make that a too big wall for to protect yourself. Maybe you need to protect yourself a little bit, but maybe through the years you have built a really strong thing there, and now it's time for to knock knock, to break it down, to break it down, because a too deep big wall work both sides. It's not only that you protect yourself from outside, but also you don't allow anything anymore to come in. So not the good things, but also not the bad things, but also not the good things. So that's your main energy. So maybe time to knock a little bit on this wall and to allow a few things to come to you. So let's see. Let's see what is for the first week. First week of... it's full moon. So here we are. Moon. So water. Moon. Scorpio, water, it's the dark side of the moon, it's the hidden thing, it's what is there actually. So the first week is really, I think, a very interesting moment for you, for to check out what is going on, what is going on. So what is the hidden part of myself? No, what is the hidden part? What is the dark part of myself? What is the lower part of myself? Where am I standing for the moment? In which part am I for the moment as well? You can see, am I in my life for the moment? In this moment of my life, am I in a situation that is finishing, that is half through, or that is beginning, or that is ending? Where am I standing actually? How am I in harmony with my female energy? Do I use my intuition? You know, there are a lot of questions with the Moonstone. The Moonstone is a very interesting stone, actually. It's also a stone for the healers. So it helps by healing. But it also helps a lot for to find things about ourselves that we have not acknowledged, because it can be hidden parts. It is very much intuition and female energy. So for the men, for example, if you feel that you can difficult connect, if you are in this position and you cannot connect with your female energy, so it's very good to wear an moonstone, because moonstone helps you to connect with your female energy. It's also very good for to connect with your healing power, a moonstone. A moonstone is always a little bit of a challenge as well, because it's, as I say, it's female, it's intuition, but it also has the hidden side of it, a little bit the dreaming side that nobody really takes for serious. So other people maybe not believing you, thinking that you're only dreaming instead of being realistic. So see a little bit what is there for you on the first week, okay? So let's go for the second week. Second week is... Wow, that's a pair. Here you have the Sunstone. So you have the Moonstone and you have the Sunstone. So, okay, it's really time to break that wall. Yeah, you don't need it anymore. You don't need it anymore, because you are in perfect balance. If you allow only the things to come to you, you are in a perfect balance. So you have this subconsciousness of you. You have this intuition. You have these gifts, healing, to heal maybe. You have all this. And then you have the Sunstone, who is putting light on that, and it's giving the energy on the third chakra. So the third chakra is like joy, moving forwards. Meditate on the sun and the moon, and you will receive whatever I'm not telling you. You know, it's much more, you're going to get much more out of it if you just meditate on those two. Just the first week, you meditate on the moon and receive the moonlight, because you have full moon on the third 31st, I think. The 31st of July, we have the full moon. So we are still in a very strong moon on the 1st and the 2nd of August. So sit in this full moon and enjoy this light and let it stream through you. And then the next day, sit outside, August, sun. What more can we have? So just take in all this power of the sun and see what can you do with these powers. Sorry, because they are the opposite. It's male, female. But those two actually, they are the one. So meditate with it. Go and find out and find for yourself what is the message there, because it's beautiful. And with this power, break down your wall. Break down your wall and move on. Let's see what's on the third week. Sorry. Third week of August with Amber. So, Amber. So Amber is like what I would suggest when you have done the first and second week, these meditations with the moonstone and the sunstone, with the moon and the sun, and these energies, and bring them in and feel, make it yours actually. Then on the third week, you meditate and see yourself sitting in this beautiful sphere of golden light. You don't need the wall anymore. Because this sphere of golden light that is filled with all this energy of the moon and the sun will give you an incredible feeling of protection, of well-being, of strength and power. So you are in this beautiful aura, in this beautiful sphere of golden light, but nothing can touch you. But you are open for anything that is beautiful and anything that can help you to go through life. So you're not blocking off the positive things that can come to you. You allow them to come to you. It's abundance on the third week. You have abundance, you have a feeling of everything is fine, everything is okay, because you have been doing all this before. So you're really in a very strong center. It's really nice. So on the fourth week for you, and this is magnetite, what does it say again? North and south magnets, it is again balance as well. It is balancing. It is the poles, the two poles attracting the two poles. So for you, it's bringing the two poles together in your being. It's the female, it's the male, it's the intuition, it's the power. It's very interesting. It is like here, because of the magnet, these two poles, it's also you, your dark side, moon, Scorpio. It's your dark side, it's your hidden side. Maybe put light on it, sun, transform it. Bring out the beauty, bring out your strong side, your powerful side. Work on your dark side, your fears, your anger, your hatred maybe. Work on them. Acknowledge them because they are part of you. Acknowledge them and let them go. And then be in this beautiful sphere, in this sphere of golden light, of amber. You can wear a necklace of amber. It's beautiful. And then, of course, in the fourth week, you will really feel really nice, balanced, in a very nice, strong place. And you will realize that this wall that you have been building before for not to be hurted, because don't forget that you're a very, very sensitive being. So you build this wall and wall and wall and wall after wall, you know, because of all the time of the hurt and don't want to show your sensitivity and all these kind of things. And you have here the tools. You have the sun, you have the moon, you have your whole being. Put it in balance, acknowledge, put yourself in a new, instead of putting yourself around with a wall, put yourself in a beautiful, strong, golden sphere. Wear an amber, if you like. And so like this you will find your balance. magnetite. So let's see what is now your message from the angels. Message from the angels for Scorpio for the month of August. And this is here. You have the black tourmaline inclusion of quartz, quartz with inclusion of black tourmaline. Here you are. And this is, of course, balance again. This is the transformation of the negativity into positivity. And everything is one. It is not one without the other. But we put everything together, we mix it together, that we transform it into a higher vibration, and that we can use it for to elevate ourselves, to make ourselves strong, and to do what we like to do in our life, to do what we want to do. So, to be one. Let's see if this is another message for you. And this is emerald. Emerald, this is beautiful green. This is listen to your heart. All the wisdom is in there. Just reconnect with your heart. Because that's also a side effect of building the wall. That building the wall is not only for the outside, but also for you. You become stronger, and not stronger, you become insensitive, because you don't want to feel anymore. So you put here like a piece of rock instead of the heart, so that you cannot be hurt anymore. But that's also completely blocked. There's no energy flow, there's nothing moving. So that's not the solution. For to deal with your sensitivity. To deal with your sensitivity, sensitivity is power. Sensitivity is, yeah, it's power, it's light, it's everything. The only thing is to acknowledge it and to know how to deal with it, to work with it, to understand your sensitivity, and not being mixed up with sensitivity and emotion. To be emotive, like to be sensitive but strong. Do here the meditation, and you will see what I mean. So anyway, you will find, be this one being, be this strong being, be you, be this sensitive being, without actually cutting off the heart. Listen to the heart. Here is the wisdom in your heart. So open your heart, allow the wisdom to come up, and be your fantastic being, your light being. Be you. So, thank you for watching. So in case, if you would like a spiritual crystal card reading or a healing meditation, EFT, whatever, you can contact me through my website. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.